Okay, we shall move to the example. So for loop example. Okay, so this is the example of for loop. So here I have taken for count is count variable here, count equals to 1, count less than or equals to 5, count plus plus. So then printf the value of count. So it is similar to the example of while loop, but here what you have to observe is initialization step, condition and increment step. So in case of for loop, so you have to write in one line. So not one statement, one line. So here three individual statements. And there are different ways of writing for loop also. So in the further screens you will come to know. Okay. So for count equals to 1, count less than or equals to 5, count plus plus, printf percent d backslash n count. Okay. So here you look at the tracing part. Count is equals to 1 is the first step, so which will be executed only once. Okay. Then if you look at the for loop, okay, what I have written example. So in the circles I have written 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So first step is count equals to 1. Second step is count less than or equals to 5. That is, it has to check the condition. Okay. So once it checks the condition, third step of execution is printf. It is not count plus plus, it is printf. Okay. So you look at the tracing part. So count less than or equals to 5, 1 less than or equals to 5, the condition is true. So print count. So tracing means just like rough work you can do. So you need not write print of percent d backslash and just for your understanding you can write print count. The value of count is printed 1. Okay. Next, after third step, if you observe, you look at the arrow mark, the program control will move to the count plus plus step. Hello. So, can you be able to hear my voice now? Hello. Now can you able to hear properly? Okay. So this is the example of a for loop. So you look at the tracing part. So count is equals to 1, that is the first step, so which is executed only once. Then count less than or equals to 5 is the condition. So you have to substitute the value of count here, 1 less than or equals to 5, so that condition is true. So immediately after that, see here, the lines, the statements count equal to 1, count less than or equals to 5, count plus plus are in the same line, separated by semicolon. But here you should not get confused with the working part, that is after count less than or equals to 5, we will not go to count plus plus, we will go to the statement. Okay, so printf statement is executed. After executing the printf statement, count plus plus will be executed. Okay, that is increment or decrement step. Okay, so you look at the tracing, first round of iteration, count equals to 1, executed only once, count less than or equals to 5, 1 less than or equals to 5, this condition is true. If the condition is true, it has to execute printf statement. So print count, so it is 1, count plus plus, that is the next step, so that is the fourth step of execution in the for loop. So count value becomes 2, so it increases by 1, so it becomes 2. See, once count plus plus is executed, you look at the arrow mark in the example what I have written, the program control will move to the second step, that is to check the condition, but it will never move to the first step, only once it is executed. Okay, now you just look at these numbers in circle what I have written, 2, 3 and 4, these statements are executed one after the other till the condition becomes false. So first round of iteration, first step is count equal to 1, second step count less than or equals to 5, third step printf, fourth step count plus plus. So once first round is completed, so what you have to understand is like second step, third step and fourth step will be executed in sequence. Okay, you look at the second round of iteration. Okay, count less than or equals to 5, that is the second step. Okay, print count, that is the third step, count plus plus, that is the fourth step. So these statements are executed repeatedly, that is again and again, until the condition becomes false. So count less than or equals to 5, two, you substitute the value of count 2, not 1. Okay, that is whatever the value is changed. Okay, 2 less than or equals to 5, so condition is true. Print count, so the value of count is printed on the next line because backslash n is present in the printf statement. Next, count plus plus, count becomes 3. Okay, so second step, third step and fourth step, again second, third, fourth steps are repeated by checking the condition. So 3 less, so new value of count is 3, 3 less than or equals to 5, condition is to print count, so it is printed, 3 is printed, count plus plus, count equals to 4. So this process repeats. So when the count value changes to 4, again it repeats, check the condition, print the value of count, count plus plus. When the value becomes 5, check the condition, print the count, count plus plus. Okay, until count value becomes 6. So once count value has become 6, okay, when it reaches 6, you check the condition, 6 less than or equals to 5, so it is false. So because 6 less than or equals to 5 is false, the program control will come out of the for loop. Okay, so this is the working of the for loop with respect to this particular example. Okay, now you can take down this example with output and tracing. Okay, so we will go to the program so that so program we can trace it in the editor part. This is the part of the program. Okay, it's only a for loop I have written. See, before we go to the program with the tracing and output, so here there are some ways how we can write the for loop, because generally when we consider the looping statements, so there are certain steps to remember. That means, see here, if you look at the things, I have written for loop in different ways, so that we have the facility to write the for loop in different ways. See, you look at the example here. Count is equals to 1 indicates initialization step, that is giving initial value to the variable. Okay, so here, see, the for loop we can write in these many ways. So we can write for loop in some of the ways as shown below. So here, instead of count, I have taken the variable I. Okay, so if you look at the example, count is equals to 1, it is the initialization step where we give the initial value to the variable. Okay, so that statement even we can write outside the for loop. That means before the for loop we have to write. Outside the for loop in the sense, not after the for loop, before the for loop. So instead of count, I have taken the variable I here. See, I is equals to 1. So if you write I is equals to 1 before the for loop, before it starts the for loop, then in the for loop what you have to do, at that particular statement, that is at that expression 1, we just put semicolon indicating expression 1 is already written. Okay, you look at this first box. I equals to 1, in expression 1, in that place I have written semicolon. Then I have written the condition I less than or equals to 5 semicolon I plus plus printf. So remaining thing is same. So this is one way of writing. That means initialization step we can write outside the for loop. Still it works. That means initialization step happens at this line I equals to 1. Then in the loop, condition, printing the statement, and then increment or decrement process. Now when you go to the second box, I have written I is equals to 1, that is giving initial value to the variable in the same line. So that means according to the syntax, okay, semicolon, I less than or equals to 5. So after I less than or equals to 5, semicolon. So till there it is okay. I plus plus I have written inside the for loop. So this is one way of writing, okay. So increment step I have written after printf, okay. So if we write in this way, so there is no confusion at all, because after printf only I plus plus is there. So after printf, I plus plus will be executed. That is after executing the statements of the loop, so I plus plus will be executed. But here in this case, you should be careful, like you should not write I plus plus before printf, because we may not get expected output. Okay, so I plus plus you write after printf. So if there are more than one statement, after writing all the statements, write I plus plus. So this is one way of writing. Okay, so another way of writing, you look at the third box. Both steps, that is I is equals to 1, initialization step and increment or decrement step, you can write outside the for loop. Outside the for loop in the sense, not in the same line. Before the for loop, you write initialization step. Inside the for loop, that is within opening brace and closing brace, write I plus plus. But whereas the condition, if you look at the condition, I less than or equals to 5, that it should not change. Okay, expression 2 should not change. That place should be fixed. Okay, If you are writing initialization before the for loop, put semicolon, then write the condition. If you are writing initialization and increment, both not within the same line, before the for loop and inside the for loop, then put semicolon in the first place, that is in expression 1, write the condition, put semicolon, okay. Then you can write I++ inside the for loop. So these are the three ways of writing for loop. Output is same for all the three ways of writing the for loop. Output is same, that is from value 1 till 5 it prints. Tracing is same, the same tracing. Instead of count, I have taken variable I. So if you look at the output, what I have written, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it prints from 1 to 5 because I value started from 1, it ends at 5. If you look at the condition, you will come to know it ends at 5. So it prints 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one more thing, the for loop without a condition is assumed to be always true as shown here. See here I have written C. See in the above three ways, I didn't miss the condition. Like I less than or equals to 5 in three boxes I have written. Okay, in three ways of writing for loop. But if you consider this last way of writing the for loop, I have written semicolon, that is initialization step. So if you miss the initialization step, that is fine. But you should not miss the condition. So immediately after first semicolon, I have written second semicolon. That second semicolon indicates I have not written condition. So if we don't write the condition inside for loop, it will assume it as true. Okay. If it assumes to be always true, then it will execute infinite number of times. So the statement is present here. So for any loop, not only for loop, for any loop, when the condition in the loop is always true, that means if it never become false, then the loop will execute infinite number of times. So this question you may expect in interview. Okay. The questions which you may expect is how many minimum number of times while loop is executed, how many minimum number of times do while loop is executed. So maximum number of times while loop is executed, maximum number of times do while loop is executed. And if the condition is not present in the for loop, so what is the thing? That is, condition will be always true. If the condition is always true, so what happens to the looping? Totally looping, while loop, do while loop and for loop. So if the condition is always true, then the loop executes infinite number of times. Okay. So these questions you may expect. So these are the ways of writing the for loop. Okay. So we have the program which is similar to the while loop program, that is printing numbers from 1 to n by using for loop. So before we go to that program, you can copy these ways of writing the for loop. Sometimes in interview, you may expect these questions also. Apart from the syntax, if there are any ways of writing the for loop. So you can write these ways. Okay. So you copy three ways with output and also the last case, that is if the for loop doesn't contain condition, it is assumed to be always true. And the last point is very, very important. When the condition in the loop is always true, then the loop executes infinite number of times. These things you follow.